think you've had in mind, thick and thin. Thick as thieves in the night, don't forget. We ride and die, 'cause you can't make old friends. You can't turn back time. You can't make old memories, or partners in crime. The good Lord knows all of those remember when. The good old days and never again. Been through it all like seven gold men. You can't make old friends. Hey, old friend. Well, it's been way too long. Turn back time. You can't make old memories and partners in crime. The good Lord knows all of those remember when. The good old days and death again. Been through it all. You're gone with the wind. You can't make old. Been way too long.
and times are strange. Here I come, but I ain't the same. Mama, I'm coming home. Time's gone by, it seems to be. You could have been a better friend to me. Mama, I'm coming home. You took me in and you drove me out. Yeah, you had me hypnotized, yeah. Lost and found and turned around by the fire in your eyes. You made me cry, you told me lies, but I can't stand to say goodbye. Mama, I'm coming home. I could be right, I could be wrong. It hurts so bad, it's been so long. Mama, I'm coming home. Selfish love, yeah, we're both alone. The right before the fall, yeah. But I'm gonna take this heart of stone. I just got to have it all. I've seen your face a hundred times. Every day we've been apart. I don't care about the sunshine, yeah. 'Cause my
Callie By, daughter of Chris and Karen, and little sister to Reese, has been one to keep us on our toes. Callie has always been a busy girl, whether she was teaching herself to ride a bike, or locking her big brother in the backyard shed, or laughing at her mom while getting a well-deserved spanking. Those three little tidbits give you a good idea of who Callie is. She's determined and willing to work hard for what she wants. She's a bit of a joker, and she's tough. Callie enjoyed hockey growing up, but her passion came in high school when she was on the volleyball team. She truly loved playing, and the highlight was when Gull Lake won the league. Callie has made the most out of her high school years, being at most social events and making friends along the way. She will have many great memories. Callie is planning to attend SAS Polytech next year to take the medical lab assistant program, or if she gets off the wait list, the lab x-ray program. We wish Callie the best of luck and know she will do great things. We are so very proud of the hardworking, kind person she is.
Now, they say people have two different reactions to a stressful situation, fight or flight. When Austin was 12 years old, he was helping his dad burn the garbage pit in the old yard. They had poured a fair amount of gas on the garbage to get it going, but just before they started it, his mom came out with a few last things that were fit for the pit. And one of these things was a large piece of silage plastic from her work. As the boys threw the plastic onto the pile, it opened like a parachute and covered the entire pit. They then lit a rag to start the fire, and as they did, they threw it into the pit, and when the lit rag came into contact with the fuel vapors trapped under the plastic, it created an earth-shattering kaboom! Austin's dad crouched down after hearing the boom and turned to Austin to say, "Holy crap!" Not that word, but the other one. "That was a big bang!" At which point he realized Austin was nowhere to be found. He had dashed back to the house like a flash of lightning. When faced with a fight or flight decision, Austin always chooses flight. Austin has a huge heart and is always willing to share. When he was about 8 years old, his grandpa gave him $20, which was a lot of money at the time. Austin took that whole amount to the school and spent it on boxes of chocolate-covered almonds. Mmm, yum. He then proceeded to give them away to his friends and even gave one to his bus driver. Actions like this are still very common for Austin to this day. He is always thinking of others. Because Austin is a true creature of habit. He doesn't like things or anything new. For example, nearly every time he is introduced to a new food, his initial reaction is, "I don't like it, it's gross." And sometimes after a huge fight, he will finally give in and try the new food. And often, it will become one of his favorites. But still, trying new things has always been a fight for Austin.
November 27, 2003 is a memorable day for me because that is the day our first daughter came into this world. She was eager to be born because she came out a month early of my expected date. I remembered her second birthday that she put up a little show that we enjoyed very much. It came to our surprise that she can sing and memorize all the lyrics of the song. If I had to pick one word to describe Althea, it would be that she's creative. Althea is also curious and likes to try new things. She tried track, volleyball, figure skating, gymnastics. Once she even joined senior boys basketball. More recently, Althea has been interested in dance. She joined hip hop and loved competing and performing. At home, she likes to make art. You can always find her in her room drawing, painting, or doing other cool projects. One time she came down to ask me if she could print a couple of things on the printer. I said yes, as long as it doesn't waste a lot of ink. But then she came back with 20 sheets of paper, fully colored. When I asked her what it was for, she said, "I'm making a life-size cardboard cutout." Then she ran up the stairs before I could say anything else. Althea's always been hardworking both in school and at home, and we will miss her when she goes off to college. In college, Althea plans to pursue a psychology major and become a psychiatrist. After 13 long years in school, you have finally reached the last hurdle. Congratulations, Althea. We are so proud of you.
Princess Kaylin, loving daughter, sister, and friend, or as everyone else knows you as, Haji. You came into this world strong and determined walking at 8 months old and have grown into a loving and caring lady that makes us all proud. The love you have for your family is limitless. The hours we have spent at the Logan Farm and Lake with cousins and family has shaped you into the person you are today. Your hard work ethic and dedication will take you far in life. Haji is the type of person that if you tell her she can't do it or if she isn't strong enough, she will prove you wrong. Oh, and she never likes to lose. Good luck to you in the future. We know you will succeed in anything you do. We will miss your loving hugs, your happy smile, and your famous death glare. Spread your wings, T-Rex. Enjoy the ride, Duke Kaboom. Grandma would be proud of you. Love ya.
Jelena Holiski, daughter of Joe and Kim Holiski. Jelena grew up with two older sisters who in many ways helped shape her kind and caring disposition. Her parents would describe her as being an easygoing child, always cool, calm, and collected, but with a witty sense of humor. She is pretty laid back, but can be a bit of a perfectionist when it comes to some things, including her studies, and has always excelled academically. Jelena loves to travel and has a passion for great food and enjoys cooking for her family from time to time. As a child, her parents can remember taking her to an all-inclusive resort with an all-you-can-eat ice cream bar. A kid's dream, right? Nope, she opted for the all-you-can-eat garlic shrimp. She was in heaven. To paint a picture of how quick and witty Jelena can be, someone once commented to her, "You look hot." To which she replied, "Thanks, my phone thinks so too, as it always autocorrects my name to jalapeno." Jelena has always stayed active through her love of sports. She has competed in cross country and track as a long distance runner and has played on the Gull Lake volleyball team since grade 6. She has also competed in countless competitions throughout the province in both dance and figure skating. Jelena worked as a lifeguard at the Gull Lake pool until COVID hit, at which point she accepted a position as a continuing care aide at the special care home. This position involved looking after our most vulnerable citizens during a global pandemic. This just goes to show her strong character and ability to step forward when faced with adversity. Jelena has been accepted into the Bachelor of Nursing program through the University of Calgary at Medicine Hat.
I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds, because you're mine, I walk the line. I find it very, very easy to be true. I find myself alone when each day is through. Yes, I'll admit that I'm a fool for you, because you're mine, I walk the line. As sure as night is dark and day is light, I keep you on my mind both day And happiness I've known proves that it's right, because you're mine, I walk the line. You've got a way to keep me on your side. You give me cause for love that I can't hide. For you I know I'd even try to turn the tide, because you're mine, I walk the line. I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds. Because you're mine, I walk the line. Because you're mine, I walk the line.
It is kind of hard for people to get to know Chevelle, as she tends to keep to herself. While she can be outgoing and fun to be around, especially when she is with her close friends and family, to her, family always comes first. For it is with her family that Chevelle lets her true sense of humor show through. Every supper with Chevelle around the table is sure to include some laughter. Now, Chevelle has moved many times throughout her life. She has lived in Labrador, Ontario, Alberta, and Saskatchewan. And in fact, Gull Lake has been the place that she has lived the longest. When Chevelle was back in kindergarten, her mom remembers getting called into school to watch her at home time. With her mom watching, Chevelle got one of the other kids to put on her boots while another classmate packed her backpack. When Chevelle was asked about it later, she simply said, "Oh, I can get ready for home all by myself, but why would I do that when I can have people to do it for me?" Although Chevelle sometimes seems shy and reserved, she isn't always that way. If you were to compliment her by saying something like, "Chevelle, you're so pretty," she's more than likely to reply, "Yes, I know." Now that's confidence for ya. Throughout school, Chevelle has always been very athletic. She played hockey and soccer in her youth, but her favorite activity has been track and field. In track, she always worked hard and was rewarded by participating in the provincial meet. Unfortunately for her, the last two competitions have been impacted by COVID. Chevelle, your mom and family are so proud of the young woman that you have become. They are also so happy to see you graduate and start the best years of your life.
Bailey is our third daughter. Bailey has been picked on by her siblings, two older sisters, and a younger brother over the years because of some self-inflicting injuries that have sent her to the ER a few times. You'd think it would be from her many activities she's participated in, either volleyball, track, baseball, or many, many years of hockey, but they aren't. It all started at age 6 when she was removing nails from an old building. The hammer slipped and the claw ended up striking her forehead. So off to the ER we went, where they taped it shut. Another time was around grade 5. She was pushed off a snow hill at lunch and broke her collarbone. She may have played a hockey game before getting x-rays when she couldn't lift her arm up to shoot the puck. The final self-injury was just a few years ago when she sleepwalk in the middle of the night and proceeded to split her front lips open, which caused us actually a surgery up in Saskatoon. So as you can see, because of Bailey's self-inflicting injuries, her siblings have found many reasons to pick on her. On a more serious note, it's the way that Bailey has overcome the COVID challenges that have been thrown her way that has proven how well she handles tough situations. Some examples are not finishing her grade 11 or grade 12 hockey season, not getting to finish the tryouts for U18 Team Canada's because the Nationals were canceled. But the latest one was at the end of May when her future plans were completely changed, where her hockey was going to take place in Pittsburgh. It was canceled. They've canceled their program. So each time she was disappointed, but she let it sink in, then moved on to try and overcome the challenge and make new decisions. We couldn't be more proud of Bailey as she heads to Clarkson University in Potsdam, New York this fall and studying to become a nurse and play hockey for their women's team.
One month after his third birthday, Alex became jealous of his sisters who were leaping off the high diving board. On his insistence, I let him climb the ladder, his little legs barely long enough for him to get up the large rungs. I followed him to the top and out to the end. And to my great surprise, he leapt into the water. He repeated this four more times, and he has been adventurous ever since. I did push his limits a few times, like when he was five and we went to the top of the ski hill at Sunshine. When we stuck our ski tips over the precipice at the start of the World Cup downhill run, he loudly proclaimed that he didn't think this was a good idea. At 11, he got on the snowboard and hasn't gotten off of it since, having many great adventures. Growing up on the ranch gave him a good taste of the unpredictable nature of animals, mostly cows and horses. He has been kicked, beaten, dragged, threatened with a stock prod, bucked off, bitten, charged, and run over. And that was just by me trying to make him get to work. The livestock were hard on him too, so he's pretty tough now. Not one to be shy, Alex shocked Mrs. Poisson in a sewing class when she criticized his torn pants, and he immediately took them off and began to repair them with the sewing machine. For April Fool's Day in grade 12, he delighted Mrs. Temeshovsky by getting his friends to hide 49 bananas in her classroom on the last day of classes before the Easter break, and telling her that there were 50 hidden.
One December, Alex delivered a Christmas wish list to his mother, with the top item being a baby brother. Quote, "Come on, Mom, if Mrs. Kerwin can do it, you can do it." But unfortunately, no amount of pleading, cajoling, or coaching could result in his 51-year-old mother delivering on this request. To her relief, there was a pet gecko at the bottom of this list. It survived the trip home from Regina in a brutal blizzard, and it still lives in our dining room, for now. Alex got 100% on his allergy report card. He is allergic to everything. That discouraged a ranching career, but not as much as his terrible luck with his own calves, with only a 50% survival rate. Once our entire herd was peacefully grazing in the rain, then lightning struck, only hitting Alex's cow. Alex is off to seek fame and fortune in a career in journalism, starting at the University of Regina this fall.
Carson Dean Krogsgaard, son of Roy and Alexis Krogsgaard. Anyone who knows Carson knows just how much this day means to him. On his first day of kindergarten, when asked how his day had went, he replied, "I sure wish I was graduated already." Well, Carson, you have battled through and have finally achieved this dream, and your parents couldn't be more proud of you. Carson may be a bit stubborn at times. He's really stubborn most of the time. But when he decides he is going to achieve something, he does. He is fearless and always up for the adventure. From riding his tricycle down the deck stairs and knocking front teeth loose, to doing countless tricks or stunts that should have landed him in the hospital, he truly is a wild spirit. Carson's one main passion has always been lacrosse. he was able to achieve his goals and play for Saskatchewan SWAT as well as Team Saskatchewan for many great seasons. Even though his mother usually did not approve of the fights and the level of contact in the sport, his parents loved watching every game and watching him do what he loved the most. When Carson is not playing a sport or at the gym, he can be found hanging out with his friends or yelling at his computer while playing video games. Carson will be attending college in the fall to become a journeyman electrician. Carson, your parents know you will continue to chase and achieve all your goals that you set in your life. They are excited to see where this next chapter is going to take you.
Grant entered our family in the number two position. He entered the world in a bit of a hurry and hasn't really let up since. From a young age, he has always known what he wants and has always pushed his way through to getting it. We have a few dents and holes in our walls to prove it. Grant is and has been an outdoor kid his whole life. One day before he was two, he was determined to climb a dirt pile. He promptly got to the top and fell flat on his face, eating a mouthful of dirt. He was often in trouble wherever we went, for touching things or running too fast. He was a bit of a bull in a china shop, and he might even still be. Brant was always excited to have friends over to play or to host his birthday party at the farm. This almost always ended up in little boys in big trouble, broken barn windows, or playing with knives, or more recently, knocking a tire off a Jeep. Brant has always preferred outdoor sports over indoor ones. He started fishing before he was two and still enjoys it to this day. He's even convinced his girlfriend to come along now too. When Brant hit grade 9, he had already been playing football in Swift Current for a few years and was ready to play in Gull Lake. He was infatuated with hitting the guy with the ball, so defense was a good position to play. Brant's other passion is track and field. At first, he tried running, but really took a liking to shot put and javelin. He enjoyed outdoor track and indoor winter track. Brant was quick to use up all of his 4-H earned money more than once to get the latest and greatest dirt bike. Most days it was better to not know about all the scary wheelies or jumps he would be doing while out riding. One day a truck we didn't recognize drove in the yard with Brant in the front seat. He had been walking home when a neighbor picked him up. He had hit a washout and wiped out, couldn't get his bike going again, and was so worried about it until he tried to take off his bunny hug and couldn't. Off to the ER we went, and home he came with a cast. 2 short weeks later, he slipped his arm out of the cast and called it healed. His most favorite winter sport is snowboarding. Alex got him hooked quite a few years ago, and those boys have never looked back. Jumps, 360s, tricks, and flips are how they like to fill their day on the hill. So far, only one concussion. Fingers crossed, it's a first and a last. Dirt biking began to lose its shine when Brant decided he wanted to drive more than ride. Brant started working at SWT and saving money to buy his truck. I'm sure most have seen or at least heard it around. He persevered and got his loan, and has been making payments ever since. From a young age, Brant loved to play with tractors, combines, and trucks either in the yard or farming the living room. He is looking forward to attending the U of S in the fall in the College of Agriculture.
Hannah has always been a strong-willed person. As a child, she was always as sweet as pie when she wanted something from you. But if she was told no, the joy would quickly turn to sass, followed by the silent treatment, for at least a minute or so, before she'd sweetly ask you again. If the answer was no, sassy Hannah would materialize once more. This would continue a few more times until she either got her way, or she stomped off to her room, taking her sass with her. As a teen, she is still a touch sassy, but sweet as pie when she wants something. Hannah is a kind and caring young lady who would give the shirt off her back to help anyone. Whenever, wherever. She likes to look out for others even when it isn't expected of her, and this especially comes across in her love for working with children. She enjoys babysitting and loves working at the daycare, where the kids just seem to gravitate to her sweet, cheerful demeanor. The kids just adore her. Congratulations on your graduation, Hannah. Keep smiling, helping others, and being a wonderful caregiver to our future.
Here we are, my boy Ian, tall and proud on his graduation day, without a doubt in my mind on where he is going. We could focus on what has been taken away from you this year, but we aren't going to do that. Your father and I have watched you shift and focus your energy on something different this year, and for that, we're truly proud. When you were a little boy, you always wanted to do things quickly, with your bright little red cheeks, moving from one thing to another in a whirlwind. You showed us your competitive nature early on when you discovered that beating your older brother Quinn at things made you happy. I remember the day you worked so hard to ride a two-wheeler bike just to beat him at it, and you did. Growing up, to keep you out of trouble, we put you in a lot of activities. There wasn't anything that you wouldn't try. From hockey to wrestling, from karate to track and field, you tried it all. And now looking back on it, it's pretty apparent that it wasn't just sports that you liked. Sports meant meeting new people, and that's what you truly loved. I once read that passion is energy. Use it wisely. And that passion for people that you have, Ian, will take you everywhere. When I tried to think if there was any words of advice to give you on your graduation day, I really couldn't think of anything. I think you already have everything you need. Never really quite met anybody like you before. I always say, there's something about Ian. He does everything 100%, hard on his sleeve, zero cares, out loud for everyone to see. So Ian, I only have two things to say. Cookies are for winners, and the grind don't stop. Congratulations, we love you so much.
I would like to introduce you to our graduate of 2021. Connor James Todd Murray is the son of Jason and Tammy Murray and grandson of Gina Morley Murray and Bernie and Jackie Zinger. Connor is a very unique young man. He has always been full of questions when he was learning something new, but you could guarantee he would remember all the answers the next time he went to do it again. Connor is very nonchalant and can be quiet at times, but boy, when he's talking about something, don't you dare interrupt him. He's a gentle soul who does not lose his temper often. He's a hard worker and loves to tinker with wood and on his trucks. He also spends a lot of time in the shop with his dad and grandpas. Connor played 2 years of hockey when he was younger and found he loved being a goalie. But during his second year, he also found a love for skiing and decided to join the race club at Elkwater the following year instead of pursuing hockey. He greatly enjoyed this, but did not have a very competitive spirit. He just wanted to go fast. We found Connor enjoyed anything as long as he could go fast, like go-karts, rides, skiing, and dirt biking. Some of Connor's hobbies include camping, dirt biking, tinkering, spending time with family and friends, and annoying his mom. He enjoys farming, watching YouTube videos on farming, and talking about farming. He also enjoys trucks, talking about his trucks, tinkering on his trucks, making mom help him with his trucks, and always looking for new trucks. In the winter, he likes to ski with family and friends and really enjoys his yearly cat skiing trip with his dad and their ski buddies. Summer brings around some relaxing time while camping and then harvest, where he's the pro at grain cart driving and his dad's right-hand man. Connor enjoys spending time with his sister Julia also, whether it's getting her to help him with his schoolwork, showing her his trucks, or just sitting and bugging her. He likes her so much, there's even talk of them moving into their own place after graduation. Connor plans on living his life after grad, and only he knows where that will take him. Please don't change, my boy. Just keep being you and doing what you do. Good luck, bud. Oh, and Connor, when you're not feeling well, try not to throw up in a full water bottle.
Margaretha spent her younger years in Ontario, where her two older siblings attended school. Even though she was younger, Margaretha was like a mother hen to her siblings. At 4 years old, she would run through a checklist to make sure they had everything they needed to have a successful day at school. One day, a short time after the kids had left for school, Margaretha noticed that her sister Susie had forgotten to take her favorite doll with her. Instinctively, Margaretha realized that the doll could not stay at home all day, as she needed her mommy. Filled with responsibility, Margaretha set off with the doll to the school. Unfortunately, well, maybe not, a neighbor came across a tired Margaretha and returned her home. So that day, Susie wouldn't get to take care of her doll at school. Katharina is Margaretha's twin sister. When they were young, they definitely kept their parents on their feet, as they were a busy pair of girls. They really did have a way of causing mischief, especially under unfortunate circumstances. Like the time after an exceptionally long day of cleaning the house when the girls needed two baths before going down for the night. And finally, getting the girls bathed, brushed, clothed, and ready for bed, Margaretha's mom decided to let the girls play a bit before setting them to bed. Big mistake. Somehow, the girls found a jar of Nutella, and the next thing you know, they were covered head to toe in the yummy, chestnutty chocolate spread. After a second bath and a second deep clean of the kitchen, it was finally time for the entire family to hit the sack. Congratulations on your graduation, Margaretha.
Eric James Olson, born December 4th, 2003. Eric was stubborn right from the get-go, and we swear he will always try his hardest to avoid taking the easy road. He was a cute kid, full of energy and little fear. He would run through the yard. There was never time for walking. He loved exploring the creek, collecting bugs, frogs, and cool rocks. If you know Eric, you may have noticed he has a bit of a temper, and you can always count on him having some kind of sassy remark or witty comeback. One day, when Eric was younger, he became furious. In fact, he decided he was moving out. He came upstairs with his bag packed, and he took off across the road to his grandma Sherry's, with no intention of ever returning home. Eric's trip didn't last long, because although he packed his bag full to the zipper, the only clothing to be found were multiple pairs of underwear. Over the years, Eric participated in many activities, including hockey, baseball, curling, football, and track. Eric doesn't have the competitive spirit like his mom and sister, so instead sporting events tended to be more about socializing with friends. Friends are very important to Eric. He always had fun throughout his life when his friends and cousins were over to explore, swim, and hang out. Eric had an artistic side, and over the years he has become a talented drawer, and his grade 10 sketchbook was filled with, of course, sketches of cats. Eric has made it abundantly clear that farming is not for him, so we hope that he finds what he is looking for when he moves to Lethbridge in the fall to attend classes at the University of Lethbridge with the intention of studying psychology. Eric, we all love you and are very proud of you. We can hardly wait to see what your future holds.
I'm quite sure they will say so.
Kiara Slavik, who's that? Haven't seen her yet this week.
Well, you know, Kiara, the one that skips school all the time and still manages to get all her work done.
As a little girl, Kiara loved helping out at home. She would put on her little apron and pull over a chair to the counter and help Mom in the kitchen. Kiara still talks about sneaking out of daycare and leaving her little brother, Jarrett, behind so she could go to work with Mom at the bakery. This job involved quality control, as she got to taste test any scraps cut off the cakes Mom was decorating. She also loved helping Dad farm. Many hours were spent riding in the tractor or combine, and when not in the field, they would sit and talk about politics at the little table in the playhouse, which was less about government and more about dolls, toys, and pets. Kiara has a very creative side. As a child, she was always crafting something. She loved the colors of the rainbow. When she first began choosing her own clothes to wear, it was important to match all her clothes. Matching, to her young mind, involved wearing all the colors of the rainbow because rainbows are beautiful. Kiara is easygoing and joins in with whatever the group is doing. But don't let her quiet demeanor fool you. She is a strong-minded, independent, intelligent, and creative person. She sets goals for herself and works hard to achieve them. Whether it's school-related or figure skating, she knows well that success means that you will fall down, but if you never get up again, you will never succeed. She always wanted to try everything, whether it was piano lessons, girl guides, or another sport. She was always willing to learn something new. At age 4, Kiara said she wanted to learn to dance on ice like the pretty girls on TV. So, when she was told to choose between gymnastics, dance, and figure skating, she knew what she wanted. Kiara's on the ice almost every day of the year. She trains in Gull Lake, Swift Current, Regina, and Saskatoon. As much as she loves the sport of skating, she also enjoys helping others learn. She began as a program assistant, and when she was old enough, she became a can skate coach. There have been many days away from school for training and competitions, and it has been worth it. This past season, she has had many personal bests. Kiara ended the 2021 season as Saskatchewan's Junior Women's Provincial Champion and also placed 25th in Skate Canada Challenge, which is a national competition. Kiara will be taking kinesiology at the University of Saskatchewan this fall. She will also continue her skating career at the ACT Arena in Saskatoon.
Brody has always been fascinated by science. Chaos theory was a topic he particularly enjoyed exploring, or maybe just causing it. His experimentation began as a toddler when he took shampoo and conditioner and squirted their contents onto the living room floor. While his mother was cleaning up that mess, Brody found toothpaste and used it to draw with. He then splashed water all over with a toilet brush. His love of chaos still continues, as is evident for anyone who enters his bedroom. He was also interested in biology. Dinosaurs held a particular fascination for him. As a toddler, his parents read many books on this topic. He was able to show off his knowledge when, at the age of 2, his family visited the Royal Tyrrell Museum. Amazed, he ran from exhibit to exhibit, joyfully yelling out the name of each dinosaur he encountered. During his kindergarten year in Wolfville, Nova Scotia, he spent many hours scouring the beaches we visited, catching and corralling small hermit and green crabs. As he grew older, visits to his grandparents' house often entailed hunting and capturing numerous garter snakes. His study of science continued when he joined the target shooting club to study motion. He got the nickname Iceman at the Winter Games during a super shoot. A super shoot is when people make as much noise as possible to try and rattle competitors. He zoned it all out and came home with a medal. Brody, like his older brothers, used sports to develop his speed, response, and reaction time by participating in football, track, badminton, and basketball. He carried on the legacy as Crazy Legs III on the football field with his knowledge of force and momentum to tackle his opponents. Just recently, he did his own physics experiment. On a drive to school, his car made some strange noises. Brody watched incredulously as his car tire, no longer attached to the car, rolled past his window. Brody's fascination with science will continue as he pursues a Bachelor of Science degree at the U of S this fall.
Zachary August Sumner, born July 15th at 7:15 a.m. Zach was in a hurry to make his presence in his mom and dad's life. He was born a little over 4 hours after his mom's water broke. As a baby, Zach had a bubbly personality and was eager to entertain anyone with his adorable antics. One funny story about Zach is when he had a bad rash on his bum. So his mom allowed him to go around the house without a diaper. While he was playing with his stackable cups, he rolled over on his back and took one of the cups and placed it over his private part and grabbed another cup and continued playing. This could have been Zach's first cup protection. Some foreshadowing of his many upcoming sports activities. As a young boy, Zach was very expressive with his facial gestures. He also knew how to change his voice to let us know when he was angry or pleading to us if he wanted something. With Zach's bright blue baby eyes and charming personality, he managed to get his way many times. This is a trait that he has perfected throughout the years. Zach was always an active boy, so sports was a way to focus his energy and talents. He had his first set of hockey skates at the age of 3. His dad shared the game of hockey and was his first coach. Zach continues to love the game and will continue playing wherever he can. Zach is a people pleaser. He wears his heart on his sleeve. He has a good heart and cares deeply for his family, friends, and teammates. As Zach's parents, we are proud of Zach's academic and sports achievements throughout the years. We look forward to seeing what the future holds for you. Reach for your dream, Zach, and you can achieve anything you put your mind to. All our love, Mom and Dad.
Jasmine has always been one to go after what she wants, although not always gracefully. When she gets an idea in her head or knows where she wants to go, there is no stopping her, unless it is a garbage dumpster or a sprinkler head. Although she always knows what she wants, she sometimes forgets to look before she leaps. Unfortunately, over the years, this has led to her share of injuries. The broken arm at 4 years old from tripping over the vacuum while chasing Joey, our three-legged cat, broken glasses and a shoulder injury at summer games, a hip out of place during a home soccer tournament, and the fat hands that suddenly appeared out of nowhere during provincial soccer last year. While she may have complained, she was determined to let none of these injuries stop her for long. After all, there were places to go, people to see, and things to do. Jasmine has always been one to make her presence known. Whether telling a story in class, yelling at her sister, or playing keeper during a soccer game, it is hard not to know when Jasmine has something to say. I am sure Jody and Mrs. Digney's mornings will be much quieter next year. Jasmine definitely believes in go big or go home. I am sure many will remember her Art 10 masterpiece project where she spent hours in the kitchen and we spent more money on fondant and flour than loose leaves and pencils that year. We are proud of the leader that she has become and know that she will stand up for what she believes in and won't back down from a challenge. Although this senior year may not have been the one she wished for, her most memorable moments from high school have come from playing soccer and attending leadership conferences. It was here where she met new people and made new friends, got to play the sport she loves competitively, and win provincial championships. Although sometimes her voice, determination, passion, and stubbornness have gotten her in trouble, it is these qualities that didn't stop her from asking questions and sending emails until she was finally accepted into athletic therapy at Mount Royal University in Calgary. You did it. We are proud of you. Happy that you will be closer to home, and we know that you will achieve everything you put your mind to.